Thank you, Dickens, for translation. Thank you, Grace Panu. You are a symbol of resistance and resilience, and your words are an inspiration to all of us in the world. I now request Professor Kancha Ilaya to come and speak a few words. Before that, we all know Professor Kancha Ilaya, and just a brief background, he's from the village of Papayapet, Varangal district, and has an MA degree in political science from Usmania University. He was awarded PhD for his work titled Political Thought of Gautam Buddha, and has worked as an associate professor in the Department of Political Science, Usmania University. And he has, through his accolades, Visa Award for his work via my Mata Hindu. He served as the director of the Center for Social Exclusion and Inclusive Policy at Manu, Hyderabad. Despite the deterrence after his critique of the Vaishya community, he stood bold against the Brahminical social order. Here we have with us Professor Kancha Ilaya.
Friends, 2016 January 17, Rohith Vemula committed a purposeful suicide. Though there are a number of students, youth, who have been committing suicide, but certainly Rohith Vemula suicide is not one among them. He committed a philosophical suicide. And therefore, I said, after Socrates, this is the first young boy in the world committed a suicide in the philosophical direction. Now, this was very clear from his suicide note. Now, his suicide note told us that the higher educational institutions, particularly the central institutions, and the whole of educational structure in this country needs to be radically changed. And in the name of nationalism, how these forces are indulging in anti-national activity, and how a new idea of nationalism has to be injected into them. You know, I was moved when Radhika Vemula was kissing the cheek of that bright boy's statue in front of Hyderabad University. And that statue is going to be a symbol for centuries to come to change this whole country and change this country towards a humanitarian country. Now, after his death, his idea of philosophical equality, annihilation of caste, development of science, as he himself thought of, you know, becoming a scientific writer, science writer like Carl Sagan, this has repositioned many ideas. You know, when Socrates died, we don't know how many people he inspired, but he inspired a Plato and an Aristotle. When Rohith Vemula, who was hardly 25 when he died, I don't know how many people he inspired really, but at the age of 65, I was inspired by him. Now look at a boy who writes a philosophical note for a future at the age of 25. And definitely he would have been a great science writer, he would have been a great scientific philosopher, perhaps caste matching Einstein in so many ways, if only this institution was not to kill him. But it did. Now I know what is happening in most of the central universities, central institutions, IIMs, IITs, and all these structures. It is not just today. Ever since they were established, they were doing actually anti-national work. And this is what Rohit wanted to change. Now what is this anti-nationalism that they were doing? And most of